you can just begin to feel that worship, feel that God is down inside of you. Praise the Lord. Sometimes you may be in the open Bible and someone reads. You know, just do what God tells you to do. The last several weeks seem like I've been putting out more fire than I have since I've been here. And somebody got on Facebook and I met a guy preaching here some on Sunday night. I'm going to preach out of the King James Version. You know, somebody got on Facebook and said, I kind of chuckled over it a little bit. I said, do you know that the King James Version that you're reading is revised? That if you go to the original King James, so I put that on there. Anyway, it's just been one thing after another. And the Lord, He spoke to me yesterday, and He said, I want you to do something for me. I said, what is it, Lord? He said, I want you to take care of the message, and I'll take care of the messenger. I said, okay, Lord. You know, as a pastor, sometimes we're doers. We try to fix things. We try to do things. And in the last several weeks, I've been trying to fix things. I've been trying to do things. I've been trying to keep the church going. And I'm thinking, we've got to have this kind of music. We've got to have this kind of music. We've got to have this kind of singing. It's just about to throw me up the wall, and I'm just going to quit worrying about it. So whatever we have here from Sunday to Sunday, just enjoy what we got. What God is speaking to me and to tell you today. And the title of my sermon today is, We Shall Give an Account to God. Now I want to talk to you in just a few minutes about how that we shall give an account to God. And in Romans chapter 14 and verse 9, the Bible says, for this end Christ both died and rose and revived, that he might be the Lord, both of the dead and the living. Isn't that amazing? That he might be the Lord, both of the dead and the living. But why doest thou judge thy brother? Or why doest thou set in naught thy brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of Christ. For it is written, as I live, saith the Lord, every knee shall bow to me, and every tongue shall confess to God. So then every one of us shall give an account for himself to God. I'm here to tell you today that every one of us is going to stand before God one day. I know that we're so used to getting up every morning and trying to fight through the day, trying to do the best we can through each day that we live in, and we try to fight through that day, we try to get through that day, and we get through that day. Some days are glorious, and some days are glorious, but they're not as glorious as the other days. But every day is a good day, but you know, some days is better than others. You know, we all try to get along and do what we need to do to work and do what we need to do. But when it comes right down to it, one of these days we're going to stand before God.
Right.
What are you going to look like when you stand before God? That's what I want to ask you today. What will you look like when you stand before God? Because it will be God that you're standing before and not man. See, man, you can hide things from man, but you can't hide it from God. You can act like you're right. You can do a lot of things, but you cannot hide from God. He has them penetrating eyes that can see through you. You cannot hide anything behind the corner. You cannot hide anything in the privacy of your home. You cannot hide anything in your car. You cannot hide from God. God already knows who you are, what you're doing, and He is so penetrating that He can go down to the Spirit and actually put your spirit in His hand and touch your
your spirit. Hallelujah. He can penetrate to the body, soul, and spirit. What I'm trying to tell you today, church, is we need to understand that one of these days we're going to stand before God. And what is your actions going to look like when you stand before God? I mean, you know, we can do a lot of things in this world. We can be successful. We can have all the accolades. We can have all the education. We can have everything we want. But it don't boil down to nothing unless you're living right in front of God. God wants us to be successful. God wants us to go forward and do things for Him. God wants us, hallelujah, to stand up and be a walking Bible. God wants us to stand up and do the good things for Him on this earth, because we are the representations of Jesus Christ here today on earth today. What I'm trying to tell you today, church, is we need to understand that God knows who you are. And whenever you take that last breath, what are you going to look like when you stand before God? What are you going to do? What are you going to do when you stand before God? What is your actions going to be like? Oh, church, we need to understand that the Bible tells us here plainly, it says every one of us shall give an account of himself to God. That means you can't ask your neighbor to help you out a little bit. You're going to be in a time in your life that nobody can help you but God. You're going to be in a time in your life, you know, sometimes when I need help, I'll get the phone and I'll ring up here lately. I've been ringing up Brother Beecham here lately, needing help unload this food. And I've been helping, and some people will help you and some come and help you. But you know what, church? When it boils right down to it, when we take our last breath on earth, it don't matter where you come from, what background you come from, it don't matter what you accomplished on earth, because whatever man thinks, I believe God thinks above that. What I'm trying to say is you need to prepare yourself now. Get yourself right with God. Prepare yourself now. Oh God, get your word sanctified and begin to call upon the Lord. Praise the Lord. Oh, in Galatians, I tell you, church, we're in Matthew chapter 12 and verse 35. Let's go there. In Matthew chapter 12, verse 35. Oh, what is your words going to sound like in front of God? What is your actions going to look like? What is your words going to sound like? Well, whenever we have that praise that sister was talking about this morning, our words will speak good words. The Bible says in verse 25, the Bible says, a good man out of the good treasures of his heart bringeth forth good things. Somebody say good things. An evil man out of the evil treasures bringeth forth evil things. But I say unto you that every idle word that man shall speak, they shall give an account thereof in the day of judgment. Oh, church, and when you begin to read that, you think, oh, my God, how in the world could I ever be justified if I'm going to have to give an account for every word that I speak? How am I going to be justified if I stand before God and I'm going to have to listen to all the words that I spoke? Oh, church, we need to understand that the Bible says out of the good man come out good hearted, good conversations. Out of the good man comes good, but out of the evil man comes evil. What I'm trying to tell you, church, you might stand behind something and try to hide yourself. You may try to hide behind something. You may try to hide behind somebody. Oh, but when you stand before God, God can see through you. He can see through your body, soul, and spirit. While He's the creator of your body, soul, and spirit. And the Lord says He wants you to run to the cross, because it's at the cross is where you find the good things of the Lord. You can't start speaking good until you get at the cross, until you run to the work of the cross and do what Jesus has called you to do and be what you are called to be. See, there's so many people in this world, they're trying to be everything but what they're called to be. We got to get to the place that we understand that we are called to be the sons of God. We speak my opinion. I'm going to speak government. And the God's government is this word that I'm reading out of today. And one thing I want to know, that when I stand before God, that my actions are good and my words are good. And I know the only way that that can happen is getting under the blood of Jesus Christ, where He died for me and you, that we can make it into the heavens of heaven and the glory of glory. Church, we need to understand our words are important to God. Don't just speak words. Oh, I just don't just randomly speak words. Don't just throw out words, just any word. Words are important to God. The Bible says in that next verse, the Bible says, for by thy words thou shalt be justified, and by thy words thou shalt be condemned. Meaning you can speak words that will justify you, or you can speak words that will condemn you.
Right.
Hallelujah. Oh, there's so many people today that are speaking so many words that condemns them. What are you going to look like when you stand before God and He puts rewind on your words and on your actions? What are you going to do? Well, church, when He pushes rewind, all he's going to hear is under the blood. Under the blood. When I stand before God one day, and you stand before God because you ran to Jesus and you gave your heart to the Lord Jesus Christ, whenever He pushes rewind, He's going to say, under the blood. Church, what I'm trying to tell you today is we need to understand that we live in a religious world. From church to church, and all you hear is religion. All you hear is politics. I don't know about you, but I'm tired of politics and religion, because I don't want God to push the rewind button one day when I have to give an account for myself and hear all those words that I spoke that I shouldn't have spoken. I don't want to hear that. All I want to hear, Brother Mitchell, is under the blood. Hallelujah. Under the blood, church. Oh, church, under the blood. Oh, when God covers you with His blood. The Bible said He hung on that cross, and the soldier pierced in His side, and out of His wound came blood and water. Under the blood, out of His wound came earth, the church. And you know why you're all mixed up sometimes? It's because the devil wants you to be accused. The devil wants you to be put in prison. The devil wants you to be put in the fiery flames of hell. Oh, but God did not prepare hell for you. He prepared hell for the devil and his angels. What I'm trying to say, church, you are the creation of the Lord. And the Bible says He's the God. When you stand before God and no one else is there to help you to bear your burdens, what are you going to do? I'll tell you what you're going to do. You're going to keep on believing. Whenever you're standing there and ain't nobody else helping you with your burdens, here's what you're going to do. You're going to remember what the preachers has told you and what God's people has told you, and you're going to keep on believing. When all hell is breaking loose around you on every side, keep on believing. When it looks like you ain't going to have enough money to pay your next light bill, keep on believing. When you feel like you're never going to get over your habits and addictions, keep on believing. Because one of these days, you're going to run to the cross. And one of these days, you're going to find Jesus. One of these days, you're going to find that living power that will give you something that will turn your life around. In the Lord's praise. I don't talk about where I come from because I'm ashamed of it. Some people just talk about it like they're bragging or something. Oh, my God, I'm ashamed of it. All I want to know is when I stand before God and He pushes that green button, that I hear under the blood. Hallelujah. You come to the cross this morning. You come to Jesus Christ this morning. You confess your sin. You do what God tells you to do. If you die this sin or tomorrow because you confess your sins, every idle word that you spoke is going to be under the blood. Hallelujah. The Bible says you're justified by your words because you confess Jesus Christ. Whenever He pushes that green wine button, He's going to see you down at the altar or wherever you was at. Wherever you was at. You know, I got saved in a ditch, doggone. Did you know that? I gave my heart to the Lord dying. Hallelujah. I knew I was dying. And all of a sudden, this man came up to me, Brother Johnny, and I called him Lord. I don't know if he was Lord or not, but he looked like Lord to me. And I called him Lord. I was bleeding out my eyes, my ears, my nose.
Hallelujah. God for something. God will humble.
You can fight it as much as you want, but God will humble. He will humble you and he will get his way. It is the humble that God uses. It is the humble that God lifts up out of their troubles and trials. It is the humble that inherits eternal life. It is the humble. It is people that learns to humble themselves before God and do just what the little sister was talking about last week. We got to learn to humble ourselves before God, because when we begin to humble ourselves, then that's when you find more grace. You find more grace when you begin to humble yourself. In the book of James, chapter 4, verse 5, it says, "But he giveth more grace." Or he said, "God resisteth the proud, but giveth grace to the humble." More grace. That's what we're seeking for today. Every day of our life, we're seeking for more grace. When we're in our humbling process, church, we have to keep believing and submit ourselves to God. The Bible says, "Submit yourselves therefore to God. Resist the devil, and he shall flee from you." Church, and he will flee from you. What I'm trying to tell you today, church, without submission, the devil's going to get in your face and laugh and giggle at you. Without submission, you can get ready. The devil ain't going nowhere. When you go to sleep, the devil will be there. When you get up, the devil will be there. You keep on letting that habit and hang up and that thing trying to mess with you, the devil's going to be there when you lay down. The devil's going to be there when you get up. Oh, but when you get down to business and you keep on believing and you say, "Lord, forgive me. Oh, God, help me with this." You are in a process. You are in a process, and God's taking you somewhere. And God says he will give you more grace. Oh, more grace. Oh, church, if you fall today, call that more grace. If you need God today, call that more grace. It's God that giveth you all these things. There's submission in your life, you will find that more grace. You will find that you have more power than what you thought. You will find, church, that Jesus will come to you and run the devil off. He says, "Submit yourself therefore to God. Resist the devil and he will flee from you." Draw nigh to God and he will draw nigh to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners, and purify your heart, you dumb mind. Now, why in the world would God tell talking to us like that? I was feeling good until I got to that scripture. God said, "If I can't allow you to keep walking with two mindsets." You've got to have one mind. See, before you can get anything from God, you've got to have the willingness. You and God have got to be one. There's something I look at it and turns my stomach because it turns God's. That don't mean I condemn it. That don't mean I say it ain't nothing. That don't mean I push it away. It means I've got to pray a little bit more. It means I've got to help pray for those people. God don't reveal us things for us to get up and prophesy and show how much we know. There's five things I know that I don't talk about in front of this church, because your business ain't nobody else's business. It's for us to pray and believe in God. But when I get to this, I go, "Oh my God." Well, we find that James said, "A double-minded man is unstable in all of his ways. Thank God that he shall receive you the plan of the Lord." Because he don't know what he wants. One day I'm a Christian. Woo! Yeah. Hallelujah. So we need to understand this today, church, that we need to come boldly unto the throne of grace to obtain mercy. Boldly unto the throne of grace to obtain mercy. The Bible says in Hebrews chapter 4 in verse 16, it says, let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in a time of need. See, we need God in that time. In a time of need. That's when we need God in a time of need. That's when we need to come boldly to the throne of grace. I wrote something down. I think I'll put it on Facebook today. But it says, from the day of Moses, from the day that Moses anointed Aaron to be high priest over Israel, to offer the office of the high priest, to establish and make atonement for people before God. The Old Testament priest had nothing but blood of bulls and goats and other creatures. Bulls and goats and other creatures. That's all they had. Bulls, hallelujah, and goats and other creatures. But Jesus atoned for us with his own blood. Seeing how our high priest died for our sins, hallelujah, we can trust that he carefully, hallelujah, he loves us carefully so much that he went to the cross and he died for us, church. What I'm trying to tell you today, ladies and gentlemen, we need more grace. Run to Jesus. Prepare yourself today and stand before him and give him more grace. Hallelujah, church. Run to Jesus. Why don't you stand to your feet and say, run to Jesus. Run to Jesus. Prepare yourself today to stand before God and give an account one day for yourselves. One day you're going to stand before Him and you're going to give an account to God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. See, I preached this sermon today in an uplifting way to tell you that God is able to change your equation. Amen. Whatever you're going through, all you got to do is run to grace. Hallelujah, that more grace. This sister was thinking about this morning. I told you, sister, God was leading you on that song. More grace. If you're here this morning and you want more grace, well, they sang a song, why don't you come now? Why don't you come now and get that more grace? Come now. The altars is open. We're ready to pray for you. Yes. More grace. More grace. As you run to Jesus today, say, Lord, I'm running to you. More grace. Hallelujah. Don't give up. Don't give up. Go on, Brother Samson.
On the Father above.
I know you're in my heart today. I believe you're going to give me.
Over my spirit.
God, you're trying to prepare you.
Glory.
He's coming to you.
Father, give me grace.
They're going to say, what do you hear? Under the blood. Under the blood. Hallelujah. Pray with me, Father. I come to you right now. I ask you to forgive me if I don't understand that. God, I ask you to put it on the board. I trust in you.
I believe in your word.
I pray that you're established. In Jesus' name. Amen. Get up on your feet.